came 8 or 7 months ago, I believe, sort of end of August 2013, escaping basically for my life. I was among the people that was in Rabah Square, as well as being part of the presidential team with Dr. Morsi. And I was basically, the police came to my house, and I knew that I was basically on the wanted list. So I escaped to Turkey. At least every month I lose friends. I get a phone call or I see a message on Facebook saying, this guy died or this girl died, or they were jailed. You know, or we don't know where they are. So, and of course, there's a personal part that relates to not being able to be with my other three kids that are there and to see my family over there. It's not very safe for me to call them because they're usually harassed by the security there. Yesterday was my son's birthday, you know. For the first time in 11 years, I'm not with him. It's difficult. And I feel terrible. I'm not surprised because we were always expecting that to happen. I mean, there were 26 people before those 500 people that were also condemned for death. And those 26 people were not even in the court when the decision was made. But that's what military-led regimes do. This is what corrupt regimes do. This is what corrupt leaders do. I think the Brotherhood are turning to become a sad story, to be honest. They still do not grasp the depth of the change that is happening. They still do not grasp that what is happening is a revolution, is not a power struggle, that the people that are going to the streets are not really interested about whether Morsi is going to come back or not. They're interested in the fact that they do not want a corrupt system to be in place. So the Brotherhood needs to understand that if that message that they keep talking about does not change, the message that they want Morsi back does not change, they'll be eventually swiped away by the revolution. That's the reality. People have actually, they've lost a lot of credibility during the months where Morsi ruled, or during the year that Morsi ruled, because they proved that in best case scenario, there are people that don't know how to rule a state. There are people that don't know how to run a country in the way that in the right way that the people want. So, they've lost a lot of credibility. Now, over the past few months, people have respected them and they have sort of regained part of the respect because of the struggle that they're in. But people are not in this struggle for the Brotherhood. And the Brotherhood needs to realize that. They need to realize they need to be part of the movement, which is much larger than them, and be part of it, and not stick to the typical political rhetoric that they have been saying since the 3rd of July and until now. I already know that they have problems inside because the young generation in the Brotherhood understand that. They realize that. And at a certain point of time, maybe even get rid of their leaders for that same sense. It's not a thought, it's a fact. Yeah, I mean, I think the least of all would be to get thrown in jail. I actually fear for my life here. We get threats here. So we get threat calls here in Turkey, you know, and if so, I already know that. I mean, best case scenario, I'll be in jail. Worst case scenario, I'll be dead.